Welcome! Thank you for joining us for today's lesson. This is part of a 13-lesson series brought to you by the Food Trust Nutrition Educators. The Food Trust works to ensure that everyone has access to affordable, nutritious food and the information to make healthy choices. In this series, we'll be covering topics such as how to shop at a farmer's market, stretching your food dollars, storing fruits and vegetables, and more. Join us every other week as we share nutrition information from MyPlate, as well as tips and tricks to eating more healthy food at every meal. Each bi-weekly lesson will be followed by a recipe featuring a seasonal ingredient you can find at your local farmer's market or grocery store. Meet our nutrition educators, who you'll get to know through our lessons or recipe demonstrations. We're excited to have you with us. For joining us. Please fill out our anonymous survey at the end of this video so that we can find out more about who we're reaching and how to serve our audience best. We hope you come back for our next lesson. See you then!
Hi, I'm Jen, and I'm a SNAP Ed Nutrition Educator at the Food Trust. Today, I'm here to talk all about how we can store our fresh fruits and vegetables. You can also watch Alex make a delicious recipe down below. At the end of this video is a short survey that helps us better improve our programming, and you may receive some food books or Berks Farm books based on your local participating market. Do you know what some of the benefits are of properly storing your fruits and vegetables? Well, one of the benefits is that it'll make your produce last longer. It'll also help it taste better, and it'll help reduce some of your waste. Now let's think about some of the produce that we might get at our farmers markets and how we're storing it at home. Let's think about some items we like to get at our farmers market. Some of the greens I like to get are things like spinach and kale, and also some herbs like cilantro. Now when we're going to the market and we're looking at these items, we want to look for the freshest, brightest greens and avoid any yellow or brown discoloration on it so that the product lasts longer at home. Not only that, but we also want to make sure we're properly storing it once we get home. So something that I like to do with my leafy greens like spinach, arugula, kale, lettuce is I keep those items unwashed in my refrigerator. You want to avoid washing them until you're ready to use them. So something that you can do once you get home is if you have a container, make sure that it's unwashed and dry, and you can add a dry paper towel to your leafy greens. Other greens like your asparagus, for example, you can cut up the stems, the bottom of it, and then you can also wrap them in a paper towel to keep them dry or put them in a plastic bag. The other thing I mentioned is getting things like cilantro or different herbs like rosemary, for example. You want to make sure that they're also dry until they're ready to use. So something that you can do is, once you have the bundle or the bunch, just wrap them in a dry paper towel, keep them in your refrigerator until you're ready to use them. So make sure you're washing your greens before use. You want to submerge them in water, give them a good rinse, and also dry them out. Your unwashed greens can last in the refrigerator anywhere from 3 to 10 days. But besides knowing where our greens are going to be stored, we also want to talk about what other fruits and vegetables can be stored and where we should properly store them too. Let's talk about the different ways of storing our fresh produce and some of the benefits. Like we mentioned, it keeps our product around longer, it'll taste better, and it'll also help us save money since we're reducing our waste. As we mentioned, there are a lot of great benefits to properly storing your fresh produce. Here are different methods that you can try at home. One thing that you can do is refrigerate your fresh items. Things like your leafy greens can last in your fridge anywhere from 3 to 14 days. As we mentioned, make sure that they are unwashed until they're ready to use. Once you're ready to use them, wash them thoroughly. and dry them. Some other items that we can keep in our refrigerator are things like our berries, cucumbers, beets, broccolis, and others. Another method that we can try at home is freezing. As the seasons change, there are certain items that you might have a harder time to find. One thing we can do to save money and to also keep things around us is to freeze them. Things like our peaches, for example, can be fresh or they can be frozen. Other ones are also things like our berries and our peppers that you can stick in your freezer. These items can last in your freezer up to 6 months. The third method that we have is countertop. Things like our apples and our bananas are ready to eat, and we like to keep those on our countertops. That's a great idea, and those items can last anywhere from 3 to 10 days. Other items that you might try having on your countertop are things like grapes, your pears, and your peaches. Not only that, but things like tomatoes also do well on their countertops. Once you're ready to use your items, make sure you wash them. One other thing to remind yourselves is that once these items have been cut into, you also want to refrigerate them. Our other method that we have here is our dry dark cabinets. So things like our potatoes and our onions are items that we want to keep in a dry dark spot. These are other items that you can also have. And these items can last anywhere from 1 to 3 months.